because it is a thriller kind of heist film. So I'm gonna let the viewer kind of see for themselves. But unlike my normal roles that I play, I do play a good guy, you could say. So you can see me on the good side of this film. Yeah, I play Trisha Brody. I'm the wife of Jason Patric's character, and it's gonna be a wild ride. I think you guys should get some popcorn, a big Coke, favorite beverage, and just dig on into the film.
Yeah, and obviously you want to keep the goodness of the movie under wraps for our audience. But dare I may say, may I ask, have you in this movie, do you have any interactions or play out any scenes with Sylvester Stallone?
I do not.
Okay.
I do not. I'm at the beginning of the film, a little bit of an anchor to Jason's character. So, you kind of see why the way he is, because of our relationship. So, a little bit of the history there, kind of ties into his, relationship and kind of war with Sylvester Stallone's character.
And can you tell us in terms of how did this opportunity land at your doorstep? Was it the traditional, now what we call the self-taping process? The audition process seems to be in person, seems to be a thing in the past since COVID. And or were you reached out for this role? The producers, directors had worked with you in the past and maybe thought had this character in mind? Or how did this opportunity land at Erin Ownbey doorstep?
Yeah, great question. So that's my dog. He's very loud.
He's
So
good.
I had a self-tape for the audition. Buddy, one second.
No problem.
Had a oops. Come here. So I had a self-tape for the audition, first go around, and then Bubba. Okay. He's very eager. Doo-doo. There we go. Okay. So I had a self-tape for the film, but it was actually for a different role. So I auditioned for that. And then I had worked with the casting director of the film before a few times and know him pretty well. And this other role, they were still trying to cast it, and I got the offer for the part. So it was kind of great. A little bit of both. I auditioned, but I didn't audition for this role. So
And
kind of
can you
fun.
tell us about the shooting on the movie? Where did you? I know there was different locations, obviously shot for this movie. But in terms of your own scenes, where did you start to shoot? And in terms of how long were you on set? Were you on set from start to finish, or was your time limited on set? Were you only there for the beginning?
So I was just there for the beginning, and we shot in Mississippi, so about an hour outside of New Orleans. And honestly, we were in the middle of nowhere, which kind of makes the film have that really cool ambiance, at least for part of the film. And yeah, just on a road. Out in the middle of nowhere in the middle of night. So we had a lot of fun. Even though I'll let you guys see what happens. But we had a good time. It was late night, you know, and lots of elements came together for our scenes in the film that I worked on. So yeah, I don't want to give too much away, but in the South on a hot night in summer in the middle of nowhere.
And Erin, in terms of working on a movie, and I know you mightn't have crossed paths with Sylvester Stallone in terms of this project, but working on a concept, working on a movie that he sort of tied to as well in terms of that film as well, does it almost send the eerie sort of spine tingling moments that you're associated? Obviously, Sylvester is probably a legend in the business that you share, dare I say, the same 90 minutes in terms of a movie that he's involved with.
Of course, he's a legend. And really has such a long and very beautiful career. So definitely someone I admire and a career that I also would love to emulate. So I'm very honored, very excited for the film. So yeah.
And obviously, I don't know when you got to see the finished project. Did you get to see it in terms of a private screening or a wrap before it ended? But in terms of seeing, we've all seen the trailer, the sort of explosion effects and stunts as well. Is that going to be was that a new experience for you when you witnessed it for the first time yourself on theater, or if you have seen it, what was that reaction like?
Well, I'll tell you what, I've not seen it yet. So when you guys see it, I'll be seeing it also for the first time, which is always a little nerve-wracking, but also kind of exciting. So I did see the trailer, and then I saw a couple little clips. But I'm gonna be just as surprised as y'all are.
Okay. And Erin, in terms of this sort of project and armor and associated with projects, does it almost have a ripple effect in terms of the business now we're coming out of COVID to have a project coming out now, which is when the industry started picking up its pieces again? It started going through a sort of a mini little boom time after an uncertain period to have a project coming out with an all-star cast. Do you hope that that'll give a bounce that goes with it?
Yeah, of course. Of course. I think just, the industry in general is in a very strange time. So, any kind of little bump is nice. But I think we're all, in it together and excited to see, how the industry evolves and shifts. So, having a film coming out right now is really nice, especially towards like the beginning of a new year. So, we'll see what happens.
Okay, and Erin, I do believe before we came on air, we had a little sort of chit chat, and you mentioned other projects that are in the pipeline that might be coming our way later in 2024, early 2025. You might enlighten us a tiny bit about that in terms of what disclosure, what you can say about it, and where can we see Erin Ownbey in our TV screens, movie theatres in the near future?
Yeah, absolutely. I will be in a new show called The Hunting Wives that will be on Stars. My character is named Allison. Depending on how the cut goes, we'll see what episode she's in. But it's a cool show. It's based off of a book about murder, women, guns. So it should be pretty fun, based in the South, in East Texas. And I also have a few indie films. I'm in an indie horror film that's doing the circuit right now called Reclaimers. And I also am in an indie film called The Grand Strand, which should be doing the film festival circuit pretty soon. So very excited for all those.
Okay, and Erin Ownbey, just lastly, before we let you go, November to 22nd is the air date when Armor is hitting our cinemas here in Ireland. What would you say and suggest to advise our audience to go to their theatre screens en masse to check out Armor on November the 22nd? And when they do sit down in their movie seat in their theatre, or wherever they watching it, maybe they're streaming it, who knows? And what's in store for them, Aaron?
Maybe some tears, maybe some laughs, and a lot of fun. It's gonna be a wild ride.
Okay, on that note, all that's left to say is from me, Jim Conlan, to our special guest this evening, Erin Ownbey. She plays the character Trisha Brody in Armour, the wife of Jason Patric. Armour features an all-star cast including Sylvester Stallone, Dash Mihok, Josh Wiggins, as we said, Jason Patric, and the one and only Erin Ownbey. But for all that's left to say is from me, Jim Conlan, to you, Erin Ownbey. Stay safe, take care, and God bless.
Thanks, Jim.